Hello, my tipsters. Welcome to Daily Tips with Monica. I appreciate you guys for coming onto this stream. I appreciate you. I appreciate you so much. Please make sure you're liking the premiere. Please make sure you share it out if you can share it out. You can share it out to all social media platforms. I appreciate you guys so much. For coming onto this premiere and giving me support. So, what we're going to do now, guys, we are going to get into the daily tips for today. Is we were bare. Do you walk in white? It's not the tip. The tips for today is going to be, before I go and get into the devotion, the tips for today will be tips on showing who you are. Tips on showing who you are. And this is the devotion for today. Do you walk in white? We were buried with him. That just as Christ was raised from the dead, even so we also should walk in the newness of life. That is, you can refer back to Romans 6 and 4. No one experiences complete sanctification without going through a white funeral, the burial of the old life. If there has never been this crucial moment of change through death, sanctification will never be more than an elusive dream. There must be a white funeral, a death with only one resurrection, a resurrection to the life of Jesus Christ. Nothing can defeat a life like this. It has oneness with God for only one purpose, to be a witness for Him. Have you really come to your last days? You have often come to them in your mind, but have you really experienced them? You cannot die or go to your funeral in a mood of excitement. Death means you stop being. You must agree with God and stop being the intensively striving kind of Christian that you have been. We avoid the cemetery and continue to refuse our own death. It would not happen by striving, but by yielding to death. It is dying, being baptized into his death. Romans 6 and 3. Have you had your white funeral, or are you piously deceiving your own soul? There has been a point in your life which you now mark as your last day. Is there a place in your life to which you go back in memory with humility and overwhelming gratitude so that you can honestly proclaim? Yes, it was then at my white funeral that I made an agreement with God. This is the will of God, your sanctification. 1 Thessalonians 4 and 3. You can refer back to that. Once you truly realize this is God's will, you will enter into a process of sanctification as a natural response. Are you willing to experience that white funeral now? Will you agree with him that this is your last day on earth? The moment of agreement depends on you. So, are you willing to experience the white funeral? What this means to me, and I may be wrong, is the white funeral is not referring to death. What it is referring to is, are you willing to stop being that person that's not living according to God's word? Are you willing to give up things to be sanctified and filled with the Holy Ghost? Are you willing to become who God designed you to become? Go look for it. Are you willing to give up some of yourself for God? Like you said, you look back. This is what this white funeral is. The white funeral is you becoming an angel for God. Becoming an angel for God. That's what I believe. An angel is, like you're living your life for the Lord. You have changed from your old ways. And you giving all that old stuff that wasn't for you up. And you're now living for God. And you're able to look back. And like I said, when some people say this all the time, when I look back at all what God has brought me from. Have y'all ever thought about that? Have y'all ever sit back and just think in your mind like all the things that you have been through in life and all the things God has helped you to overcome and have brought you through? You'll get an overwhelming feeling. I'm gonna be honest. God has brought me, like some folks say, God has brought me from a mighty long way. God has brought Monica from a mighty long way. Monica ain't no saint. Monica is not a saint. I may look innocent, but I have done things that I am not proud of, and God has got me out of. If it weren't for the grace of God, I would not be here. By God's grace, you ever someone heard that song, God's Grace? I made it this far by the grace of God. It was God's grace. It was God's grace that got me this far. It was all God's grace. I'm gonna leave that singing to Anita. But don't eat no more snacks. Go somewhere with the muffins. Yes. Yes. It was God's grace that got us this far. And we have to thank God that we ain't that person that we used to be. We have to praise God. We ain't going through the things that we used to go through. Because guess what? It ain't you no more. You have turned into, you are walking in the white. You're walking in the white. You want to walk in the white. The white is God, the goodness of God, God's mercifulness, God's powerfulness. Let me tell you, I promise you guys, sometimes you do have to think about all the things you have went through in life and all the things God has brought you from. And you know it wasn't nobody but him that helped you through. Because guess what? You wouldn't be where you at today. So thank God for where you at in life. Continue to strive and ask God to heal you from things and help you through things and build you up when you feeling torn down by things and read your scriptures. I need to do better at that as well. Let's pray and do better at praying. It's so much in life that we can do to give God the glory. So thank you guys so much again for coming. That is the devotion. I appreciate you guys again for coming onto the live stream. I mean, not the live stream, the premiere. I appreciate you guys so much. We're going to get into now. We're going to get in on tips on showing who you are. Oftentimes, those who are living a lie do not like to reveal who they are because they don't feel it's safe to reveal who they really are. They are afraid to be themselves. Because of judgment by family and friends. Give me one moment. Sorry about that. Because of, okay, so let me read that over. Tips on showing who you are. Oftentimes, those who are living a lie do not like to reveal who they are because they don't feel it's safe to reveal who they really are. They are afraid to be themselves because of judgment by family or friends or co-workers. Some have been bullied when they were younger, so that's what causes them to not be able to show who they are. Avoiding being your authentic self is choosing to be who you are here. Avoiding being your authentic self is choosing not to be who you are. Here are some tips that can help you. The first thing is hardship reveals who you are. Allowing yourself to be open and raw is a very intimate experience. To get to know yourself and other people, to see what you are like in your vulnerable moments, is revealing yourself at your lowest moment. Sometimes it can be crying with tears running down your face, or when you are emotionally drained or going through a breakup. These things are tragic and can affect your life and dreams. While going through something that is going to change your life, you can either remain in your misery or get up and learn from your choices and make a clear path for yourself. So hardship reveals who you are. When you're going through things in life, and the way that you handle the situation, handle the hardship, shows who you are. Some people feel like just saying, I'm okay, I'm okay, I'm okay, I'm okay. They want to hide it. They want to hide the pain. Why hide your pain when you can get some help? Why hide it? I understand some people like, well, you gonna judge me. Guess what? I'm gonna tell you, it's people out here that won't judge you, that will love you for you and will not judge you, will have an open mind and an open heart and able to listen to you and help you as much as possible. But you have to make yourself vulnerable. You have to open yourself up and let people who really want to help you in. If you always saying, I'm strong, don't nothing bother me, well then people will go on by their business and be like, you know, she said she fine. She ain't bothered. But when you know, when you get home late at night and she got an outfit. When you get home late at night and you think about it and you're crying and you're just covering, you're trying to keep a strong face because you don't want someone to say anything negative. That's hiding who you are. It's okay to not be okay. It's okay to not be okay. Some people are real good at listening and understanding and being a shoulder to cry on. So when you're going through a hardship, be vulnerable, be open. Don't try to make it seem like, oh, I got it all together. When you know deep down inside, you want to get a chair and throw it through the window. Or you want to lay down in the bed all day and just cry yourself to sleep. Knowing that's how you feel on the inside. Get that stuff out. No, get that stuff out and let it show that you have a heart and that it does bother you. The breakup did break your heart. No, I'm not okay. No. No, I'm not over. You know, I'm not over how someone treated me. Hardships reveal who you are. Excuse me. Every time I get on here, I yell. I'm so sorry. That's not professional. The second thing is how you act when you are upset. If getting angry or disappointed in someone's involves in someone involves you being verbally or physically abusive to someone, you're revealing yourself in a negative light. Doing this makes people not want to be around you. Being this way makes good people in your life walk away. What you need to do is take the time to process the situation that happened and ask yourself, why am I upset? And be relatable to others when you are upset. You will be better off. I know this is not easy, but we have to know how to control ourselves when life is not being kind to us if we'll help us in the end. Okay, so when you how you act when you are upset, how you act when you are upset shows what kind of person you are. I'm gonna be real. Some people, they get mad, they'll tell all your business. They will tell all your business, and they will try to defame you and speak negative of your character, just J-Lo, just because they are mad at you. They will go on a tangent on tearing you down. They will go on a tangent on tearing you down and try to reveal all your personal business, what goes on in your house and things like that. So you have to be careful how you deal with people. People ain't gonna want to be around people that every time something happens in their life, or something ain't going pleasing in their life, they want to take it out on you. Jayla, no. If something that's going on pleasing to their life, then they want to go and on the attack and want to attack you. Don't be that person. Don't be that person that wants to tear people down and cuss people out and disrespect people and want to fight them all the time. We can't do that. We can't. That's not showing a good representation of who you are. If you know you're not really a mean-spirited person and that you just trying to get your point across, and sometimes you just get upset, and just sit down before you speak. No, think before you speak. Jayla, you have to think before you speak. So don't do that. Think before you speak. Assess it. And verbalize how you feel, but you don't have to, like, I'm about to learn that too, because, like, let me tell you, because sometimes I get mad, baby, the next thing you know, I done seen red, and I'm going off, I'm saying some few choice words, because I have did it, I just did it the other day, and I'm Lord forgive me for it, but I felt like at the time, before I just blew up, you know, and we have to stop just blowing up and acting out of emotion and just see a situation for what it is and just act accordingly and say whatever you need to say, but you don't have to be ugly about it. That's what I'm going to have to work on, because sometimes I feel like, hey, if you say something that kind of like offended me, I'd be really wanting to say something. And then, you know what I'm saying, like, and if I get upset and I'm agitated, I'm going to just go off from the dope, and I'm going to have to do better. I'm going to have to do better. If you feel like I'm feeling, then I know this, the second tip is something that you're going to have to work on, showing who you are when you are upset. Now I'm not gonna get in Walmart, get upset at the cash. Like, I had watched this video, and this lady was at Walmart, and they ran out of tissue or something like that, and she fought the worker at Walmart because they didn't have something that she was looking for. So she's going to fight the worker at Walmart. Now, I'm not acting all like that now. I do have some sense. But you know what I'm saying? So act like you got some sense, honey. You know, don't fight the people at Walmart and the cashiers and the essential workers. Do not fight them. You know, they want to go home to their people is their family as well. The third thing is how you treat those who can do nothing for you. If the only thing you care about is the people that are more powerful than you, you need to evaluate yourself. The people I am referring to are the rich, good looking by society standards, those people you really feel you can benefit from, but only thing you're doing is prove that you are very shallow. How you treat people in a less prominent position that who are not famous or well off or powerful is very telling who you are really are and what you really is about. If you are tired of the way things are and are committed to another approach, all you have to do is change your habits. So all this is to me, these tips, only thing is it shows your character. It shows what kind of person who you are, and it shows what type of character you have. So the thing is, it says treat those who, how you treat those who can do nothing for you. Some people, they just want to be all about, they want to be on the in crowd, and they want to be the with the most powerful person in the world, and the most handsome man, and the most of the in crowd, the high society sedity people, you know. So they're gonna look down on a person that don't have much. They're going to look on a person that don't have much. And like I said, you do need to evaluate yourself. Please believe me, you ain't always had it as much as you have now. Somebody in your family had struggles, or you had a struggle. But we have to learn how to not to look down on people that really don't have as much as you have. Some people just look down on people that, like, some people treat someone that, like a custodian, they look down on a custodian. They look down on people that clean the toilets and treat them like nothing. They'll look down on the man that's picking up the trash for maybe feeling like he is nothing. Don't do that to people. They are human too. They just because they may not be as well off as you or have more money than you, you may have more money than them, does not mean that you look down upon them. You don't look down upon people. Because guess what? Sometimes things happen in life that can knock you back down and it'll humble you. So be careful when you're doing that. The four things is who you are when no one is looking. Who you are when no one is looking. You are definitely who you are when people are not looking. This is a true word. It is easy to do the right things in life when someone else is watching and taking notes. But what do you do when they are not around? If you're lying, cheating, hacking, plotting revenge, taking advantage of someone, choose what is easy, you are revealing an unhealthy way of living. If who you are in private is different from who you are in public, then you are not being your true self. Be a kind and welcoming, honest, thoughtful person, and others will receive that. Who you are when no one is listening or not around you? Are you being that mean-spirited person? Are you being that person that's going out taking advantage of people and treating them any kind of way? Are you that person that sit up here and steal from people? So in order to not be that way, you have to evaluate yourself and try to be better. If you're not that type of person that steal or do anything like that, and you just a real genuine person, be that genuine person. You don't have to take anything from anybody. Just work hard for everything you have. We all need to work hard for everything that we have. Some people they this way with you one day, and then the next day they only want the next day they'll talk to you, and then you be like, Lord, I don't even have the energy for this. You don't have the energy for people is to act one way and then to act the next way another time. Don't nobody like wishy-washy people. I don't like wishy-washy. Because I ain't wishy-washy when I'm like this. I wasn't wishy-washy when I met you. So I ain't gonna be wishy-washy with you now. So if you ain't got nothing to say to me, then hey, I just go on by my business and I won't say nothing to you. That's just how life is. So this is how it is. Be that person who you're projecting yourself to be in front of people. Be that same person when no one is looking. Flip it. I understand everybody got hills and valleys and mountains to climb. We all do. We all have things that we need to work on in life, and there ain't nothing wrong with that. Some people they do feel like they're perfect and that, oh, I don't never do nothing, I don't never offend nobody. But let me tell you something. Some people they're good at covering up who they really are. But let me tell you something. When you get to really being around a person, some people actions show you who they are. Some people actually shows that they are for themselves. They're some. Jalen. Yeah, I forgive that. What I was saying was, don't be like when I learned that some people they are very selfish and they're all about themselves, all about me. As long as my stuff is done, as long as my life is perfect, if your life is going to the wayside or your life is bad, I ain't got time for you. If it's something that you need from me that I can truly help you with, then I ain't got time for that. So it's some real selfish people out here in this world. I tell you, boy, let me tell you, man, God will reveal people to you if you sit back and watch. He will reveal people to you who they really are, who they not who they trying to portray themselves to be, but God will reveal who people really are. That ain't really being true to themselves and ain't being true about themselves. They just trying, they got to fake it till they make it. See, I ain't got time to be faking it till they make it. 'Cause me, my head, I just can't. I'm just gonna be Monica. I'm gonna be Monica till the day I die, and it's just how it is. You know. Who you calling? Hang up. Hang up. Give it here. No, don't call nobody else. Okay, the fifth thing is the types. Don't sit down. Jelly, give that to him, please. Give it back. Okay, so the fifth thing is the types of relationship you pursue. I'm sorry, guys. These kids are being very distracted today. So the types of relationship you pursue. Oftentimes, those people you who have not healed from past relationships and relationship trauma will continue to pursue those people that remind them of their troubled past. But remember, you are not your past. Your past is your story, but it is not everything. You don't have to relive it every day. Who you are attempting to date, marry, or befriend can reveal who you are. Hold on just a minute. But you have to remember, you are not your past. Your past is your story, but it is not everything. And you don't have to relive it every day. Hey, be quiet. You don't have to relive it every day. Who you are attempting to date, marry, or befriend can reveal who you are, but you have to be fully healed. You can also date people because it reflects who you actually, how you actually feel about yourself. So, what I'm trying to say, y'all excuse me. For some reason, the kids will not sit down. Allow me a moment. Okay, guys, so I'm back. I'm so sorry about the disruption, but hopefully I can get through the video without any more disruptions. So what we're going to do, I'm going to get back into the daily tips. I know that the last thing I read was the type of relationship you pursue. So, as it was saying, if you are not healed from a past relationship or a traumatic experience in a relationship, you tend to seek people that are just like the ones that you just got out of the relationship with. But you have to remember, you are not, you know, your past. You have to let that past go, or you'll continue to meet people that are just like the ones that you just got rid of. And every time, who wants to deal with being physically abused all their life? No one. Who wants to be with someone who's verbally abusive to them? No one. So you have to pursue people that has the same values as you, the same, want the same things as you, want to make you happy, and not about physically and emotionally and verbally abusing you, because, you know, they don't really want to be in the relationship with you, but they want to take advantage of you. So, you know, don't let a bad relationship make it to where it shows up in your character. Because that, yeah, you know, all these things are like character flaws, you know what I'm saying? They are really like character flaws. So the relationship that you try to pursue, make sure it's a relationship that's worth pursuing and not a relationship that's going to tear you down. Because many times it can be like that, and you don't want that for yourself. You don't want to be in a position where people are like not wanting to be around you because, you know, or be in the midst of your environment because you're in a situation that's not good for your health or your children's health and things like that. You don't want that. You don't want that at all. So the sixth thing is, how often you admit your own mistakes and failures. Mistakes, hey, remember what I said. Don't be loud. Mistakes and failures are a natural part of our life. If we don't make a mistake or fail, we would not be able to learn anything. You may take responsibilities for your actions and it's honest about the part you in your choice in life you may have made. You may not want to acknowledge your troubles because you may feel like that you are not able to deal with them and afraid to mention what had went wrong because you may be worried about how other people will view you. Accepting responsibility for your actions and how you cope with failing will reveal who you really are. So, admitting to your mistakes and failing, admitting to making mistakes and being in a relationship, a bad relationship, you made a mistake and broke somebody's heart. You made a mistake and not hit nobody because you don't put your hands on nobody. But made a mistake and mistreated someone that didn't deserve to be mistreated. Take ownership for that. Take ownership for mistreating people. Take responsibility for your part you played in someone else's demise or someone else's heartbreak or someone else's doing things that are not right. Take ownership to that. Don't be that type of person that just feel like just trying to make it seem like, oh, I don't do nothing. Or you say, well, that ain't my fault, and you never take responsibility for nothing. You just going to just be like, oh well, it happened. Don't feel that way. Take ownership. Say, yes, I did it. And I apologize. I'm not that person no more. Because let me tell you, your past is your past. It ain't nothing you can do about your past. But what you can do, and I know I say that a lot, but it's the truth. Your past is your past. It ain't nothing you can do about your past. But ain't nothing you can do about your past. Nothing you can do about your past, but your future, you can change your future. So admit to your mistakes. Take ownership that you have failed at doing certain things in life, and you're trying to overcome it now. That's the most important thing right there. So, what we're going to do now, guys, that is the daily tips with Monica. We're going to go ahead and do a recap. I'm sorry, guys. I'm just a little tired and my head is still a little bit hurting. So I'm going to go ahead and recap. This may not be a long video and I'm so sorry, but the next video will be a little more. I'm gonna try to be like, go ahead and work on my tips. So, and when I get off work, I can just go ahead and get into it instead of just waiting and getting my, before I get my children from daycare. So, these are the daily tips for, we are talking about today, tips on showing who you are. The first thing is hardship reveals who you are. How you react in a hardship or going through something shows who you are. The second thing is how you act when you are upset. When you are upset and you're doing things that are acting out of character that is not good and not projecting something positive, then that shows who you are. How you treat people that can do nothing for you. So make sure you're not looking down upon people. Don't look down upon people. The fourth thing is who you are when no one is looking. When no one is looking, what type of person you're trying to be or are you being? Ask yourself that. The fifth thing is the type of relationship you pursue. So if you're pursuing those negative, toxic kind of relationships, then it shows what your character, it shows who you are. You are accepting of anything. That's what it's saying. The sixth thing is how often you adjust to your own mistakes and admit to your own mistakes and failures. So How you admitting your failures and your mistakes is another way of showing who you are. Some people don't know how to take ownership or nothing. They blame other people for the things they have gone through. So that is it for the Daily Tips with Monica. I appreciate you guys for all the love and all the support you guys give me. If you ever wanted to contact me, or you want the daily tip, or you want the daily devotion, let me know. I can give you that information. You can go to MJJ Family. You can email me at mjjfamily2020@gmail.com. It's a great way of getting in contact with me, or you can inbox me on Instagram. As well, guys, if you want to purchase the MJ and J Family Mukbangs merchandise, you can purchase our merchandise. I'm still working on the Daily Tips with Monica's merchandise. It will be coming out soon, so look forward to that. We will be coming out with a mukbang this evening, later on this evening, so look forward to that. As well, guys, we got to keep the positivity pushing. First, before we do that, I want to give a special shout out to the TBT squad. That is, it's me, Winston, yes, honey. Yo, it's your boy Leo, the Man Ray Kings, and let's talk about it with the need. If you guys have not connected to the TBT squad, go ahead and connect with us. I am as well part of the TBT squad, so. If you connect with us, we're all great content creators. We're all speaking and putting out positivity. So, guys, if you want to connect with us, please connect with each and every one of us. Before I let you guys go, I want to leave you guys with this.
Mommy, I want to see you.
No, go sit down. No, your food is sitting right there at the table. Move. I just want to leave you guys with this. Winning is not a sometime thing. It's an all-time thing. You don't win once in a while. You don't do things right once in a while. You do them right all the time. Winning is a habit. Unfortunately, so is losing. And this is what said by Vinci Lombardi. So stay trying to win. Be about winning. Be about being positive. So if you're winning, you won't have time to be losing. So y'all, we're gonna keep this positivity moving. We're gonna go ahead and go to It's Me Winston channel. And we're gonna listen to him and get the positive message that he's going to put out for today in his morning talk. Y'all, if you want to donate or give to the channel, you can cash app us at MJ and J Mom 118. So we're going to go ahead and go to It's Me Winston channel. Y'all have a wonderful Tuesday. And I'll see y'all on Wednesday. And y'all have a great, great day.